Whether they wanted to or not, young transients drifted into the hobo life. They became outsiders, relying on the charity of farmers and housewives.
You had to really be on the bum, asking at back doors for handouts. And a handout was something they'd give to you in a sack to take, you know. They call it a lump also. And a knee shaker was when you'd sit down on the back porch and they'd bring you a tray of sandwiches or something to eat. And a sit down was when they'd ask you to come in and you could eat with the family.
Eventually, hunger drove most young hobos to begging on the streets.
It's hard at first for a 16-year-old kid to overcome shyness and just to go up and ask somebody for money. Panhandling is hard to do, especially coming from the kind of environment that I did. But you learn it in a bloody hurry when you're hungry and haven't eaten for 24 or 36 hours. Getting food from a restaurant is kind of a technique you learn. You go walk back and forth in front of the restaurant or cafe and look for a man on a stool, usually at a counter. And you buzz right in there and speak right up to the waitress and give them the story. You know, have you got any work to do in exchange for something to eat? And sometimes they would respond. An owner usually wouldn't. He'd just say, get the hell out of here. But the kicker there is that that if you do get turned down, one or the other of these people that's beside you, there's a chance they will pipe up and say, it's okay, lady, give the man his breakfast or give him a cup of coffee and I'll pay for it. And then you're home free for the time, you know.
Above us came this detective with a club. He moved down the ladder and swung at us to knock us off. He missed, but we felt the swish of his club. Then we saw his foot come down a rung lower. He wouldn't miss at this range. It was either jump off or be knocked off. The train was going faster and faster. We jumped.
Young people had no support whatsoever. None. Zero. You were totally 100% on your own.
Nearly every letter of the thousands we received from former road kids stressed the unforeseen miseries of freight riding.
I looked up to see the train enter a tunnel. The smoke overwhelmed me and I couldn't breathe. I panicked and crawled to the top of a boxcar. When I came to, the train had stopped at a water tank. I was violently sick, coughing up black coal smoke. I coughed it up for a year afterwards.
To avoid being arrested or beaten, young transients slept in temporary camps set up by hobos along the outskirts of towns. The camps were known as jungles.
A jungle is just a little trans-story place where you can camp while you're waiting for your train. And they were in little groves of trees where somebody would be sitting over a fire or maybe had his bedroll out. And up in the branches of trees would be hanging things like mirrors, so you could shave, and sometimes even razors. You sometimes carry your own blade in a wallet, but there would be the razor, and it was nearly always a Gillette, and it all fit.
Quite often in hobo jungles, there's residents in there, old jungle buzzards, as we used to call them, that live there for weeks or months at a time. And you quite often get permission from them if you want to do something. Hey, I want to wash my clothes. Is that okay down there? And you know, he said, yeah, well, go downtown, bring us back some cabbage, and then you can do whatever you want, and you can have some of the mulligan tonight. That's the way the way it worked.
This hobo and I, we hadn't eaten for quite a long time. 4 hours in that boxcar, we were telling each other what we would do if we had a dollar. He would have bought half a dozen hamburgers. I wanted a deep dish apple pie. And then we changed. Well, maybe in addition to an apple pie, I'd take half of the apple pie, and I'd have something else. We got off the train. And on the outskirts of town, the first building was a diner. And we saw the proprietor standing in the doorway. And when we got up to where he was, he called us over and he said, you know, I've been watching you walk up that road and you have a hungry walk about you. I think the fact that I was young, I looked young, softened the hearts of many people.
You couldn't catch the freight train usually in the yard unless it was real late at night and you spotted where the bulls were. That's the railroad police. And if you knew that they weren't on your trail, you could catch one slowly as the train was moving out of the yard. But generally speaking, especially in the daylight, you'd have to go just outside the yard. Therefore, you'd have to catch the train on the run.
Towns which were struggling to take care of their own residents could be actively hostile to hobos.
In Sheridan, Wyoming, we were rounded up by some police officers who told us to walk through town in front of their car. Everyone was looking at us, pointing their fingers and laughing. They made us run up a long hill going out of town by prodding us with their car. They bumped my brother when he got tired and slowed down, knocking him to the ground.